One way to save some serious cash is to pay less interest on your loans. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use a spreadsheet and a secret formula to figure out how much total interest you can save if you make extra payments on your loan every month. The first thing you want to enter is your annual interest rate. Suppose it's 3%. Type that in as 0.03. Next, convert that annual interest rate to a monthly interest rate. Divide it by 12. In cell B2, type equals B1 divided by 12. You get 0.0025, 0.25%. After that, we have to enter the term of the loan. That's the number of years that the bank gives you to pay it back. For a home mortgage, that's typically 30 years. It will be convenient to convert this to a number of payments. Since there's 12 months in a year, in cell B4 we can type equals 12 times B3. Now let's enter the loan amount. Let's say we have a mortgage on a home for $500,000. Enter that in cell B5. Now let's figure out the monthly payment that goes toward P&I, which represents principal and interest, not taxes. That can be done with the spreadsheet's built-in PMT function. In cell B6, type negative PMT of B2, comma B4, comma B5, the monthly interest rate, the number of payments, and the loan amount. The negative sign is necessary because this is outgoing money. It gives us a positive final answer of $2,108.02. This is how much money you're going to have to pay every month for 30 years to pay off the loan exactly in those 30 years. Because of that, your total payments can be found to be the monthly payment times the number of payments. In cell B7, type equals B6 times B4 to get $758,887.26. That's the total amount you pay over 30 years. But wait a minute. That means you paid a lot more than you borrowed. Your total interest paid can be figured out in cell B8 by typing equals B7, the total payments, minus B5, the loan amount. Your total interest paid was $258,887.26, more than half of what you borrowed. Now we're getting to the interesting part and where we can use the secret formula. What if you make an extra monthly payment to principal of $1,000 every month? How much total interest will you save? Start by figuring out your grand total monthly payment, the extra payment to principal plus the original monthly payment. In cell B10, type equals B9 plus B6. The thing that makes this difficult is that we can't just take this new monthly payment of $3,108.02 and multiply times 360 to get our total payments. Why? Because the number of payments will go down. We will actually pay the loan off before 30 years. Of course, that's another benefit of paying more on your principal every month. So we are now at our secret formula. This is a secret formula for the new number of payments that we're going to have to make. Here it is. In this formula, N is the number of monthly payments, M is the grand total of the monthly payments, including your extra payments to principal, P is the principal itself, which is the same as the loan amount, and R is the monthly interest rate, not the annual interest rate. LN stands for the natural log function. This formula gives an approximation for N. It won't be a whole number, but it will be close to the true value of N. It says that N is approximately the natural log of M minus the natural log of M minus P times R, all divided by the natural log of 1 plus R. Now let's make a spot where we have the spreadsheet compute this approximate value of N, say in cell C3. We'll type the numerator first, natural log of M minus natural log of M minus P times R. Now we can also write the denominator as natural log of 1 plus R. This gives an approximate value of 206. We can either round that number down or just use it as is to figure out our new total payments. Take that number, 206 in cell C3, and multiply it by the grand total monthly payment, giving us a new total payments that is indeed much less than before. What is the new amount of interest paid? We can take the new total payments in cell C5 and subtract the loan amount in cell B5. The new interest paid is a bit over $140,000. Now we find the interest saved for this loan. In cell C9, I'll type equals B8 minus C7. The interest saved is about $118,489. But the really great thing about this is you can easily make changes and see what happens. For example, if I have a different loan that, say, has a 5% interest rate, and maybe it's a term of 5 years, and a loan amount of $20,000, this would be more typical for a car, my ordinary monthly payment, principal and interest, would be about $377. If I make an extra $1,000 monthly payment to principal, I will pay it off in 15 months instead of 60 months, and I will ultimately save almost $2,000 of interest.